Step number one, do your homework. Figure out what your interests are. Number two, you want to pursue an entry-level certification. Number three, you want to get your resume professionally created. Number four, get you an account created on LinkedIn. One of the things that makes searching for a job hard or seeking that first role is a lot of times we tend to over-exaggerate how hard that position is going to be because we've never had experience in that role to begin with. Hey, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'll be sharing with you how you can land your first gig in IT in four steps. Step number one, do your homework. You're gonna wanna do your homework. And what I mean by this is figure out what your interests are. Now, I'm not sure exactly where you're starting at on your journey, but if you're not actually familiar with the fields of IT, IT is composed of a lot of different departments. You have networking, cloud, cybersecurity, programming, automation. So figure out which one of those tracks aligns with your interests and pursue that one. Once you define the field that you want to pursue, well, now you can take that and go to Google and search in, let's say for instance, entry-level roles for networking. You may find some help desk positions. Look through those job descriptions. And here, when you skim through and see what the skills and what they're actually looking for candidates to have on the technical side, you'll likely see some preferred certifications. So whatever that might be, whether that's some certification for software development or a networking certification, you're going to want to look into that because that's going to give you insight into what that field encompasses on the technical side. I'll give you an example. Let's say you find your CCNA in one of those job descriptions as one of the requirements. Well, Google the CCNA curriculum. And then you can use that to figure out what topics in that field that you need to get familiar with. All right, so moving on to number two, once you've identified your interests, which field you want to pursue, and you've looked at the job descriptions and the requirements that they're looking for, next, you want to pursue an entry-level certification. So you've discovered it. Now it's time to go over that information, whatever that curriculum was, and start getting exposure to it. Find you an instructor. You don't have to learn this from scratch, but find you an instructor out there. You have some amazing resources out here nowadays. You have YouTube, which is free. And then you also have some paid platforms like Udemy or the amazing folks over at CVT Nuggets. Now, you don't need to know everything in terms of, you know, how to do everything in the role that you've done. That's why it's an entry level role. There's a lot of leniency, but you do want to know, say, 60% of the jargon, just so that you're not learning everything from scratch. For one, it helps you out as well as helps the company bring somebody up to speed a bit quicker. Lastly, while you're going through your certification studying, and you can just study or you can study to pass and acquire that certification that sort of validates your knowledge. But in addition, you can also do some home projects. And home projects are a great way to get yourself to get your first bit of experience that you can put under your belt that shows that you're familiar with whatever track that you're pursuing. And in the instance of a software engineer, you may be able to Google online, what are some programming portfolio projects? For a network engineer, you may do a home project of building your home network. Hey, if you're enjoying the video so far, go ahead and smash that subscribe button so that you can stay tuned for future videos where I'll be sharing networking tips and, you know, pivot techniques that you can use to skate on your IT journey. Yeah, that is just retarded. Okay. Moving on to number three. Now you want to get your resume professionally created. And this is really a must. Hire somebody, pay the $50, $60, kick it out. It's worth it. And here's why I say that. You never get a second chance to make a first impression. I'm sure you've heard that before. And I'm speaking from the standpoint of someone who came into IT and I came in with a cashier background. So before coming into IT, I never needed a resume. I had no idea how to fill it out. I tried to, you know, put one together, but it just looked like throw up on paper. I'm sure somebody can relate out there. But really paying that $50 to get somebody to make my experience and tailor it towards the job that I was applying for look good on paper, that was a relief. And it's one thing that you can sweat less when you're trying to pursue that first entry level role. So I definitely recommend doing that. And overall, your resume is just a great way to showcase some of the things that you've been doing prior to applying to the job. What have you been studying for? Home projects? You can list that in these entry level roles. It's a great way to communicate you know, how much you know about the role you're pursuing. It also shows that you're interested in the role that you're pursuing to a certain degree. Moving on to number four. I held up a five for a second. Moving on to number four, get you an account created on LinkedIn. If you're not familiar with the platform, this is essentially the corporate world of Facebook. This is literally where you go to build connections, build your network, and find opportunities. There's a plethora of opportunities. I mean, that's what the platform is built for. If I were you, I'd say 50% of the people that you connect with on LinkedIn starting out should be recruiters, because it's the fastest way to connect and put yourself out there when they make a post for a job listing. Be one of the first people they call. Get lined up for that interview. Lastly, you can take those names that you Googled earlier in terms of finding that entry-level role that you're interested in, and you can search for it on the platform. This will show you a list of entry-level positions that show up for that role. And building on top of that, in terms of entry-level positions, a great way that you can get started is think about pursuing an internship. They usually roll around in the summertime, but it's a good way. The pay is, it varies. You may get paid decent, you may get paid, it may be free. It's like a 3-month program. You get insight into the role. It's almost like the company tries you out, you try the company out, but you get that exposure. One of the things that makes searching for a job hard or seeking that first role is a lot of times we tend to over-exaggerate how hard that position is going to be because we've never had experience in that role to begin with. Hey, well, that is the end of this video. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, go ahead and smash that subscribe button and stay tuned for the next video where I'll be sharing what are 3 things that I'd do differently if I started over as a network engineer. As always, thanks for viewing, and I'll see you in the next one.